Hello, Lennox here, and welcome to an episode of Space Engineers. In this episode, take a look at five mods. The Grid Pickup mod by Math0424, the Enhanced Upgrade Modules by Sherbert and Bad SCR, the Arcade Development Heavy Shift Tools by Arcade, Kayed, and the Tunnel Tube by Iron Hospital, and lastly, the Ganymede something Maglev Landing Gear by Sorgonus. So, how about we take a look at the upgrade modules first, since, you know, they're right there. Right over here. In first person. I'm Ben. And here you see two different types. We have the Zenith upgrade module and the Quantum upgrade module. They do both speed and efficiency, so they do double, which is pretty handy. So they say things will be able to process faster, and no wait, with efficiency and yield. He's already find out. And bonk. There we go. Yeah, productivity and efficiency. So you'll get more, about, you get an extra 0.8 more out of productivity, and they'll be a little bit more efficient than vanilla variants. It's kind of handy. Now we can have 8 of these on a single refinery, and you'll be able to gain quite the benefit. Because you'll have to put more than just 4 of the other ones. Yeah, you won't be able to do it. Having 4 of these is far better than or vanillas of either one, which is helpful. Now the quantum one is even better. Well, let me show you. There we go. You can see the productivity and efficiency is much higher in comparison, which is pretty handy. Does that productivity mean you get double? Cool. And that's per slot, and these take up 2 slots. So, you know, pretty damn handy. Although the quantum ones are not easy to get a hold of. Why? Wrong button. You can see, they're a bit more expensive to build, but there's also the quantum core. You can't make that in a refinery. You have to find it. I think it comes in drop pods or something? I didn't read up how you get it. No. Back in a second. See if the mod page says how you get the quantum cores. Turns out you can't get them. They have to be added through like creative mode or something. There is an additional mod that the person's released to make the quantum cores buildable. Because he's intended this mod to be used on the Lost Civilization server or something? Ah, oh, jeez, I already forgot. So yeah. If you add the additional mod that gives you the ability to make quantum cores, you can do that. Have these much more efficient modules. And they're very powerful refineries. I wonder how well they work. No, they won't work too well on a assembler. There's only one of the two things actually work on them. So anyway, how about we move on to the Tunnel Tube by Iron Hospital. Right, it's a bit there. Oh yeah, I already did show you the build cast. Anyway, here, you see, it's just a simple glass tube to connect two areas together. And it is airtight. I think. No, I don't think it is. Or maybe it is. Although I'm kind of worried, well, confused on why there's no glass visible. Despite the fact it is there, and you see there's 5 bulletproof glass in the recipe for it. As well as 2 small steel tubes, 5 steel plates, and 2 interior plates. So it's cheap to make, it has a simple tunnel from one area to the other. That's all there is to it. That's a good break it down. I accidentally double clicked. Oops. Well, that's that gun. And now it's back. So yeah, that's all there is to it. It's like a big long tunnel. Like that. Am I crouched? Yeah, it was. You can just go all the way through here. Next, we'll take a look at the egg lift, which you can already see is doing its thing here. Now, the intention with the maglift is to have a landing gear that can rest further away from whatever object it's landing on. And as you see here, I put it in reverse where it's holding an object up, like my little tunnel drone. A little drone I created to make tunnels for people to walk through. Pretty simple design. And you see the maglift itself. It is quite basic in design as well. And I think it's just as expensive as vanilla? Oh my. 195 steel plates, 35 construction components, 30 computers, and 5 motors. And compared to vanilla? Less motors, more steel plates, and has computers. Huh. So it's more expensive. But it has quite the range of what it can lock onto, and there's no physical contact, so things can't go kaboom if anything weird starts to happen. Which is handy. And as you can also see here, you can use it to hold up objects and stuff. Now, it is only available on large ships, so you can't put on small ships, unfortunately. I think that may be a planned feature in the future. It would be cool. Now, when you give this little thing its own little landing pad on the bottom there. If we ever come to use it again. So next, how about we take a look at the grid pickup mod. Now, the grid pickup mod is quite simple. It allows you to pick up grids with your hands. So I can do that. I see a little line where it goes. Whee! Ow. So you pick up very small grids, go high up and drop them. No. Oops. Let's grab that before it lands. Ah, ball, that's going to cause some damage. Oh, this sucks. Or not. Does this seem to take any damage? Well, that's weird. Yeah, you press F to pick things up, press F to put things down, and if you're in default control mode, you'll jump at the same time. Yeah, I've done that up though. Since I never use F to jump or go up, I just use spacebar. Anyway, let's head over here. Now there is a limit on the size of grids you can pick up. Because, you know, it uses the physics engine to calculate how you move these things around. And yoink. As you could see when it went flying up. And you can also throw things like that. You also came up with a game mode as a hot potato. Where you use a warhead instead of a little ball like this. Man, that would be crazy to do. Now, apparently you can use large grid stuff as well, but I have a feeling blocks like this may be a bit too heavy, but there are smaller objects. Let me see. Yeah, a full block is too heavy to pick up, but something like that should be pick upable. Yeah. No. Why? What about its small ship variant? Can I pull that thing around? I can. I guess it only worked on small ships. Just the one that worked on large ones too. Yeah. Oh well. So yeah, let's just throw things around. I'm guessing if you drop a tool, it'll let you do that one as well. But I need to spawn one in to show you. So if you have a gun, if I press T or F, well, left click, or press T, I'll pick it up. If I hold F. Oh, don't work on tools. Never mind. Of course, I want it wood. Oh, I wonder if that lets you throw around voxels and other materials. Maybe. Then again, this is a grid thing, so it might only work on grids. Yeah. Oh well. Anyway, let's. Where are you gonna go? I don't go very far. Me. So anyway, how about we take a look at the last mod for today, which is the heavy ship tools, as you can see right here. At the moment, they're both available for the small ships, but the grinder is only available for the large ship. Well, the grinder is the only one that you can put on large ship at the moment. Can't put the drill on it yet. As far as mount points, that's the only place you can mount the drill on the back. It's got large and two small. This one has a large and four small. And this has all two of the small ports that small ships usually have. Not sure why. Oh well. And as for the bottom, you can see it's got a conveyor port right there. Just connect it on the back. And you see, it will probably grind down a large area. Unfortunately, I didn't actually set anything up to display their ability. Unfortunately, I don't even have time to set it up right now. Oh well. So, the build cost. This is a total of 120 steel plates, 37 construction components, 4 small steel tubes, 12 motors, and 5 computers. As for the ship breaker, that's the same. And that's more expensive at 170 steel plates, 55 construction components, 4 small steel tubes, 12 motors, and 5 computers. Now I'm going to set up the red ship. And also, the other one I was building last time couldn't fly, so it kind of broke the base. Kind of annoying, but oh well. So anyway, I'm going to spawn one in, and then we'll get something ready to display the grinders. Then again, why don't I just park the small ship down here? For the red ship. Yeah, may as well. And we are back. Decided to use a skiffer to demonstrate the grinder. I need to put some more gyros in this thing. Hold on a sec. I should be able to find some good gyros. And a bunk. I really do need to update all of my designs. They're all outdated. Here we go. Let's rotate this bugger. Let's head on over to the red ship, which I'm currently using the maglevs to keep it up. You know, stop falling when I grind certain parts down. Yeah, time to slow down, skipper. Don't go too far. Maybe I should replace this. You know, when the Azimuth mod pack, or the Azimuth remake, update 5 comes out, I replace its thrusters with those ones. And here we go. Let's put those there, put that on. And turn it on. Let's approach and see how quickly you can grind down the red ship. Well, no idea what's going on here. Not sure where those bars are. Should I go forward? Is that thing going around? Well, this is not going according to plan. It looks like they don't actually work. There might be something wrong on my end. Might be missing something. Well, that's a shame. I want to show you it grinding. Never mind. So anyway, I'll have links for all 5 mods in the description below. So you guys can play around with them yourselves. And actually try out the heavy tools and see if it's actually working. Should be. I don't know why I don't have it working. No matter. Also, if you have any suggestions of what mod you'd like me to see, go to my Discord that's linked in the description below and leave a link in the Space Engineers chat. So anyway, I hope you've all enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye bye.